Highlighting the value of NASA, the next resupply mission to the space station, and a milestone for the James Webb Space Telescope. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. During a speech at the 36th Space Symposium in Colorado, our Administrator Bill Nelson discussed the benefits and value of NASA, from the economic boost and jobs created by endeavors like our Artemis program, which will help prepare us for future human exploration of Mars.
Its missions will make new discoveries, advance technologies, and show us how to live and to work in another world.
To promoting STEM education and inspiring younger generations to continue exploring and to build a better future, one in which groundbreaking missions such as our James Webb Space Telescope could help us gain unprecedented knowledge about the universe. But the administrator also pointed out that while
we will always look upward and push outward into the unknown, central to our mission is protecting this planet.
Which we do by monitoring weather, natural disasters, and climate trends from space, making NASA research available for industry to create spin-off technologies for practical uses on Earth, investing in innovative cutting-edge technologies, and fostering international partnerships, which are vital to the success of future human space exploration.
We are a can-do people as a nation, and as members of a global society. For America to lead in space, and in turn to continue to lead here on Earth, it will take all of us working together.
The next SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft to the International Space Station will deliver a variety of science investigations, including a new robotic arm demonstration that could potentially be used on Earth for disaster relief, and a study to determine if metabolites from grape skins and seeds used in winemaking could help prevent and treat osteoporosis. This is the company's 23rd commercial resupply services mission to the space station for NASA. Our James Webb Space Telescope has completed its final tests, and preparations are underway to ship the observatory to its launch site in Kourou, French Guiana. After it launches, Webb will take about a month to fly to its intended orbital location nearly 1 million miles away from Earth. Scientific operations are expected to start about 6 months after launch. It will be the world's premier space science observatory when it launches in 2021 and will solve mysteries in our solar system and teach us more about the origins of our universe and our place in it. We named Teams Air Company of Brooklyn, New York, Hago Energetics Incorporated of Thousand Oaks, California, and Sweet from the University of California, Berkeley, winners of the agency's CO2 Conversion Challenge. The contest challenges problem solvers to come up with ways to convert carbon dioxide, a principal element in the atmosphere on Mars, into sugar, which astronauts could use to make food, medicine, fuel, and other useful products. Learn more about this and other opportunities to provide solutions to NASA at nasa.gov/solve. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.